Here we are in Amsterdam. This part of the world is the heart of the world's trade in diamonds. Diamonds are a commodity whose exchange has made fortunes for people here. They're something that can exchange for enormous prices.
I start to show you very small diamonds of only 14 points per piece. 1 carat is 100 points, so they're 14% of a carat. I have here 65 points of a carat. It's a river color, so the best color again, with small inclusions, SI, but it's not visible to the naked eye. I show you the princess cut again, the square diamond. It's 3 carats. It's a white color, Wesselton VSI1. I show you top white pure diamond, a 4 carat emerald shape. And I will give you the prices. The 2.54 brilliant cut cost 48,000 euro.
48,000 euro.
The princess cut is slightly bigger. It's white diamond VSI. It's about the same price, 49,000 euro. And the 100% pure emerald cut of 4 carat top white cost 108,000 euros.
108,000 euros for something which is a bit smaller than my fingernail. Wow. Yeah. But there are people willing to pay a very great deal of money for diamonds.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think it's strange that something like water, which can save your life, which you pay so little for, and diamonds, which they're pretty, but they hardly make the difference of life, and they're incredibly highly priced.
Yeah, but also, of course, diamonds they're actually small. You can always bring them with you, but they're such a high in value. And also, to buy a diamond, you also give a kind of emotion.
The diamond industry is of particular interest to economists because of what we call the diamond water paradox. You may have met this idea before. Why is it that water, which is essential to life, fetches a very low price, and diamonds, which are relatively useless, fetch such a high price? Does this suggest that people behave irrationally? Well, no. Economists have long since resolved this paradox, this apparent contradiction. So what's the explanation? Well, what determines the price of a commodity is its marginal utility, not its total utility. The price of all units of a good is set by its marginal valuation. The total value to consumers of water is much higher than the total value to diamond consumers. But now consider marginal utility. The marginal valuation of a diamond is high. One additional diamond would attract a high price. But an extra unit of water we value at a low amount. The marginal utility, the utility from the last diamond consumed, is much higher than the marginal utility of water, the utility we get from the last unit of water consumed. That is the diamond water paradox, and you can see it diagrammatically. We can sketch the market for diamonds and the market for water, and it'll look something like this. Here we have a demand curve and a supply curve for both water and diamonds. And in each market, we have an equilibrium price and an equilibrium quantity. So given that the two markets are in equilibrium, diamonds have a much higher equilibrium price than water. And the higher price for diamonds reflects its high marginal valuation, whereas the marginal utility, and therefore the price of water, is low. So the marginal utility of diamonds is high, the marginal utility of water is low. But now let's think about the total utility. Total utility is the sum of all the marginal utilities. Now if we have a look at the diagrams, we're looking at the area under the demand curve up to the equilibrium quantity. And if we do that, we can see that the total utility for diamonds, the sum of all the marginal utilities, that area under the demand curve to QE, is much less than the area under the demand curve to QE for water. It's just that we can't really show the total utility for water, because for small amounts of water, willingness to pay is very high. But total utility is clearly much greater for water than for diamonds. We can also measure the consumer surplus for a commodity, where consumer surplus is the total utility less the amount that consumers are spending on the product, that is to say, P times Q. So if we look at the market for diamonds, we've shaded in the area of consumer surplus. So water has a low price because although total utility is high, marginal utility is low. Diamonds have a high price because although total utility is low, marginal utility is high. But sometimes it's difficult to show this diagrammatically, and we really need to use mathematics to be able to demonstrate this properly.